We're 700,000 Black people in this city. Like, this feels like the largest experiment on Black people in modern history.
Face recognition risks exacerbating existing disparities within our criminal justice system. Communities of color, who are historically over-policed, are disproportionately likely to be the targets of the use of new technologies, including face recognition. Documents that we received from San Diego indicate that they know they're using license plate readers and face recognition technology between 1.5 and 2.5 times more on communities of color than their proportion of the population in San Diego.
Since 2016, Detroit has rolled out what's called Project Greenlight. With Project Greenlight, there's these green flashing lights that they put in particular neighborhoods within the city to amplify that this is a crime-ridden area, a low-income area, an area to be wary of, and that's under 24/7 police real-time surveillance. What they didn't say, though, to these businesses was that facial recognition was a part of that process. And now over 500 businesses, including some schools and apartment buildings, low-income housing, with these cameras all throughout the city, the Detroit Police Department has been using it to pull their images for facial recognition. You look at a city like Detroit, where the median income is $26,000 a year. I mean, this is literally one fell swoop and a flick of a button. You could totally marginalize the entire city.
Face recognition makes mistakes. It's not the most accurate technology right now. And it makes more of a certain type of mistake on people with dark skin, as well as on women and young people. It doesn't matter how accurate this technology gets. It's not magic.
We are nothing by ourselves. This is coalition work, and it's tremendous and incredible opportunity to come together and be on the right side of history. And I can't stress enough how important it is to resist this